Hello, welcome to Lori's DIY Life. This is Lori. Yay. Believe it or not, this is a good thing. I thought I had messed something up. And it ended up being a simple button and okay. I got my Spellbinders order. It wasn't supposed to come till tomorrow. And it came today, and it actually came early today. So we're going to open it up. It was here when I got home from work, so yay. And I'm off for a week now. And this is perfect. Oh. So I'm in the kit where I get the, excuse me, card kit of the month. I get the ABG dies. I get the APG. No, large and the small die of the month. Not APG. No, maybe I do get the APG. I don't even know what I get. Okay, so this is the small die of the month. Now, I got this set up once before, and then, so when you connect on, this is supposed to connect in here and here, and I wasn't that crazy about it. It looks good here, but here it looks like they didn't really connect. I don't know, but we will see. We'll try that. The large die of the month is a bunny, it looks like. Look at the, oh, and a little duck. And what is that? A bunny, a duck, and I don't know what that is. Or maybe it's a little lamb coming out of the shell. Yep, a little lamb. Hello peeps. Make your own hello peeps card. And what do? They move up and down. Oh my goodness. It's a lever. And they move up and down. Oh yes. We will have to do that. That's for sure. And then the amazing paper grace, ABG. Flowers in the jar, and it's sweet. Mini 3D vignette floral mason jar. So, I got acetate, the jar, then they put in the lid, the vignette, because you could make, I guess, different things, and then you have the different flowers. They come like those, and you put them in there. Oh, that looks like that's going to be a job. But we'll play with it. And we'll see how it turns out. Now for the card kit. And I don't even know what this is going to look like. It is Celebrate Spring, March 2021. Here we go. Lucky friends. And there's a little rabbit. He looks cute. The best time. Oh, it's got, oh, I'll just show a little bit of the back. What it shows. Nice, right? I like it. Okay. We will see. So, of course, we wait for this for last. Oh, look at, excuse me, folks. Oh, look at the cute little animals. Look at the little rabbit, and the fox, and the deer, and the squirrel. And it seems like this is the new big thing, right? These woodland critters or animals or whatever. It's like the deer came, seemed like they took off at Christmas time, and then everybody came out with these woodland creatures. And but they've had like the hedgehog. They've been doing a lot up with that, on, you know, with Spellbinders House. Okay, and then we got the gemstones with the gold on them again. And they seem like this seems to be kind of a going thing with them now. It's these gemstones with this glitter on it. For me, 3D butterflies. Pretty. Very, very pretty. And we've got our dimensional stickers. And these are not like that puffy plastic stuff this time. They're more just like a foam, which I actually kind of like these better, I think. So that's good. And of course, we got our foams and our double-sided tape and our dies. Let's look at these dies and see what's in here. I'm just going to lay them out right here. Oh, look. Little bitty shamrock. I don't know what that is. Here's the little rabbit. Here's the thing that makes that frame. I mean, it don't have to be a frame. That's how they used it. And then, oh, this will cut out, you know, a banner for your words. Now there's some little teeny tiny dies in here. I don't know. Does this go back to the stamp? Let's see. This one goes to this one. I don't think those. Nope. They don't go together. There's no clover. There is clover, but it's not like that. Here we have some leaves. We have flowers. I don't know. That would be a flower or a leaf, I guess. Here's some little stems. Here's another little leaf sprig thing. Another little tulip flower. This has to go here, right? No. I mean, it looks like it's got to go. So good, we got some of this stuff we can get cut out. This is a kind of a square thing, a little small. Good luck. And then another flower. And then another little flower. So that's a nice little bunch of dies. Now we'll put them back in. And we'll make a card. Usually what I do is make a card. Right now when I get done showing you everything, I use the die cuts and just make a quick simple card. And then, come back and make other cards with this other stuff. But, you know, it's so easy and quick to do one that I just, it's a nice way to show you what's in there and what you can do with just opening up the box and getting going. You know? It's nice. I think it's nice. And of course, we get our card blanks and envelopes. And it seems like they changed the size. Am I crazy? Weren't they more kind of taller and more narrow? These look, I think these now are like 4 1/4 by 5 1/2 or something. I don't know. Anyways, it doesn't matter. Okay, the dies will go through later. Let's have a look at the paper pad. That is super pretty. I don't know what that noise is. Super, super pretty. 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 Ooh. Different. See, to me, I don't know what you do with that. You know, you're just going to end up with this one corner. Maybe. Yeah, you know, just the one corner of it. And that's different. Wow, these are really different. Okay, that's pretty. Foiled. You have words. Nice. Looks like just green paint. I love this kind of stuff. I really do. I mean, and to me, this one's really pretty because it's colorful and like that, you know, distressed like that. But I don't know why, but I just love it. It's like old, old wallpaper or something, you know. Pink wood look, shamrocks and berries. Oh, that purple's pretty. We have some pots. Windows. This is different than what I expected. Green dots. Little rabbits. And I think we're starting over again. Yep. Okay. Maybe they call it gold. I say it's yellow. Kind of sunshiny yellow. And then, of course, that gold paper that's so awesome. And this would be a lavender. And, of course, the blue. But there might be, see, that's the green. So, no, they're not going to have that blue green in here probably this time. Pretty papers. Pretty, 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 pretty. Love that pink. And then like a grayish color. I love that pink. Okay. Now I'm going to put this to the side over here. And I'm going to look through these and we're going to decide, or I guess I'm going to decide. Let's decide what we're going to use, what we're going to make, and then we'll figure out the paper from there for our matting and stuff. Okay. So, let's just leave it out. Okay. the year. A big shamrock. I'm casting a shadow, and I don't... Let me see if that'll work. I hope that doesn't fall. Maybe does that help? Just bring it this way more. A three-leaf clover, not a four-leaf clover. A bow. Of course, some hearts. Here's the little bunny with the little shamrock. Here's a different little bunny. Lovely. And that's big. Right? That's good size. Here's some flowers. Perfect together, so I guess that's what these are. It must be a boy and a girl. And here's a pot. The best. Of the sprigs, and a different color of that. Here's some grass for the bottom, and a window. Oh, that's pretty. Okay, here's the four-leaf clover, and a flower. I'm seeing a theme with these flowers. Oh, look at the little fox. A little cup, the best time, so lovely, wonderful. I'd always pick you, a little arrow, days, happiness, treasure this moment. Grateful. Another treasure this moment. Good luck. Friends forever. Love always. Sunny days. Fun times. I don't know what this is. I really don't know what it is, but it looks like a waffle. I'm sure that's not what it is. What is it? I don't know. Here, you want breakfast? Here's some milk. Cherished. Here's a wheelbarrow. Oh, look at the little squirrel. I love that little squirrel. Okay, I guess we're going to have to use the animals. Here's some little banners and a frame. Little butterflies. Here's a jar with hearts. These are just round things. You are my sunshine. I guess that's like the inside of a log, but it's different colors. Here's a little bird. There's even a little bird. Okay. So, I'm going to say, love this. Happy days. I've got a cup, but I don't really see anything else to go with the cup. So, unless we want flowers coming. Maybe. We would have to kind of cut a slit in here and then put flowers in. And that would be pretty kind of small here. And I don't know if we could put a bow. Bow on the bottom and then flowers coming out the top. I don't remember that many stem-looking flowers here, see? Even if we did like that, that's not going to work. So, I'm going to use the little animals. Let's get the background. These die cuts are not, to me, not as good as what we usually get. Sometimes we get two bags of them. We didn't get two bags of them this time. That might work. Or even that one. Yeah, maybe we'll do that one. Okay, I'm going to use this one. And let me get the paper cutter out. And let's get started here. The first thing I'm going to do, and I always do, is measure the card. Right now, because I'm using the dies, the die cut shapes, not the actual dies. We'll do that probably in the next video. Okay, so it's 4 1/4, yeah, about 5 1/2, and I think it used to be 4 by 6, but 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. So 4 1/4. I'm gonna want something behind it, so I'm gonna go. Let's do 3 1/2. Gives me 3/4 to cut in half. 3/4, and then 5 1/2 is gonna put me here. No, 5 1/2 is gonna put me here. 4 1/4, that's a really small match. Okay, that's about what I wanted to do. That looks small, but I wanted to leave this big because I want to use some of this colored paper back here just to give it a little more interest, because I don't know if there's going to be a lot of background on this. So I'm going to find a color that I like with it. And I'm going to do the blue. I think I will. Make it look like sky. I don't know. So this one I'm going to do just under the 4 1/4. This is going to be my true match, I guess I'll call it. And then just under the 5 1/2. Okay. And I'm going to go ahead and glue these down right now. You know what? I use this stuff that came in the kit. And this is double sided, but this is not. Okay, now remember, when I do these, I'm just doing a quick job. Just to give you a demonstration. But you would, of course, take your time and try to get closer to the edges and all of that. Sometimes I do these quick jobs and I think it's not put together that well, and they end up that they are, and I can use the cards. somebody. So, you never know. Yep, that wasn't very good, was it? Okay, get this off. So if you've seen my videos, you've seen me do this a million times. Well, not a million times, but every time I get one of these kits. And sometimes I like the die cut so much that I'll make a few cards with them. Oops. I don't see this necessarily being that kind of situation, but sometimes you just never know. They're good to have for, you know, if you need to do something real quick. Oh boy, did I mess that up. I really need it to come that way more. Oh well. It still works. So if you get, you know, an invitation all of a sudden to a birthday party or, you know, something all of a sudden comes up and you need a quick card, these die cuts in these kits, these Spellbinder kits, are awesome for that because you can put a card together really quick. Don't think we haven't all been there where, you know, you gotta stop on your way to get a card and, you know, we have all been there, so. Pull out the die cut to make it and personalize it, you know, if it applies. Center it. I'm just gonna eyeball it right now because we are already 28 minutes into this video and I'm not real sure what animals I'm using or nothing yet, so we will see here. And we can always use one of these stickers if we want. Okay, here's a little hedgehog. Let's find these animals. Here's a little fox. Little squirrel. These two look like they're looking up to something. This one. What else did we have in here? We have the little rabbits. There's another squirrel, the fox. Hedgehog. I thought there was more than that. Wasn't there a deer in here? Maybe not. I thought there was, though. Maybe that's the sticker that I'm thinking. No, wait, here it is. Here we go. Here's the little deer. Squirrel. don't know if I want to use a rabbit for the little woodland creatures. So now, friend. We just put a friend banner across there. Friends. And yeah, and there's always usually two of each. So, we got friends. Okay, and I'm going to put one layer here. So, see, it's not quite long enough to fit. But it will fit this. So if I keep these little guys in here, I can use both of them. Yes, I'm not going to use the little hedgehog, so I guess I can bring this down more. Bring the deer down more. Okay, good. Bring the deer down a little bit. Put this down. It's going to be a little shy. Then we'll put the fox and the squirrel in another layer of grass. And then, and this of course too will be a little short, but okay. Okay, and we got that. Now we got the little friend's banner coming across. And we had birds and butterflies in here somewhere. All of a sudden my nose is getting runny. It's gosh darn these allergies. It was pretty small, right? So, I might have had a good time finding that butterfly. But I truly want to use the butterfly fluttering around. He pops out of here. And I thought there was one that was already loose. Seeing a different butterfly, but I wanted a butterfly. Flying, you know, one or two anyways. Was what I was thinking. Maybe I was wrong about the butterflies. Here's, oh no, that's the bird again. That's the same bird I thought. Maybe it was a different bird. Okay, I don't see any other. Oh, here we go. Here's a butterfly. See? Yeah, it looks more like she's flying. I didn't want just one butterfly. Oh, let me go ahead and take this one out of here if I can. He's in here pretty good. Look, there's two of them. So there's what goes with the butterflies. And the little hearts. A little heart. Yeah, there's a lot going on, but I think it turned out cute. So I'm going to start putting them down. And I'm going to start with the deer. I think I'm going to use glue, folks. I know I always say that I'm going to do it with what's in the kit, but I think I like this one enough. I think I'm going to use it. And I don't know about that double-sided tape on these animals in the grass. So I'm going to kind of use that, leave that grass here just to give me a gauge of where he sits, because I have a really hard time getting them back where I like them. And so that'll give me a good gauge. Not gonna worry too much about his legs, because I'm gonna glue the grass down over them. Okay, so right about here. I hope that's about right. Okay. Now see, all that glue came out. Oh. I was hoping that it wouldn't do that. But it did. Alright, now we gotta put glue on the grass. And so I'm just going to go on the bottom. And a little tiny bit up some of these bigger things. I don't want to try getting it on all the little pieces, because then we'll have a mess. For sure a mess. And I'm going to just try to center it a little bit. Now these little guys are going to go down. See, he should have been over this way more. That's right. is it could snip some of the grass since it's not going to show. But too late for that now. And then how do you know exactly where to snip, right? That little squirrel is adorable. I'm going to leave the fringe here, and then I'm going to use that to just kind of gauge how I want the bird, and then I'll come back and put the fringe down. Now with the fringe, I would put the double-sided, since I already got the glue going. That look cute. I think what I'm going to do, maybe it's dumb, I don't know, but where you go, there it is. I'm going to use a dimensional on the heart and just get the heart up a little bit. So I'm just going to snip it. I should have been more careful putting it on. I don't know what made me think that heart should be puffed up, but I do like that. I'm thinking of putting some stones down here. Some of these little gemstones. I and a little teeny tiny one. Well, it's not tiny, but the smaller one. Go here. Yeah, it didn't need those stones. I think. Let's see if I can get them off. I think because I got them soon enough, I can get them off. Otherwise, I would have messed up my paper and everything. There we go. I like better without stones. It could use another row of the grass. And I could always make that. You can always make that grass, you know, but just to go straight across. So, if I had, see, that's such a different green, that's not even gonna work. See, even there, you see the green that's in here. See, that's really light. That might be just way too different. I'm gonna go ahead and try it. Could have made this wider, this strip, but oh well. I wasn't thinking, I guess. Just make some of them kind of big. Some of them kind of small. And it'll go on there. See, I didn't do it wide enough, but I'll finish doing it so you can see what you think. I don't know, somewhere I probably have a die for this, you know? Which would make it a lot easier. I might have to look for one and keep it with this little set. But when you do it yourself, you can be a little more, you know, it's going to be a little bit more natural because it's going to be, you can make it and make sure that you're not using the same pattern. You can make some wide blades, some thin blades, you know. You could make it look manicured if you wanted to. Where they're all the same height, it's up to you. I like to just start cutting. There's one piece in my hand. See, if I'd have made it thicker, I could have left a bigger strip down here, and then I could have. I could still watch. Actually, maybe I'll do that. Let me finish this. This is turning into a really long video, I think. gonna try to do is use this strip on the top part and then just put a plain strip underneath of this color, and maybe it'll just make it look like it's long enough. So I'll just take another piece. But I'm gonna want the bottom to be kind of straight, so I'm just gonna cut it here. Try to make sure I cut it long enough. I'm sure that's long enough. Oh yeah. That's long enough. Okay, so I'll just this too wide now, because that's going to be, yeah, too wide. I can't tell, it's a little bit off, and it looks like I got wider as I went to here. As long as I keep the bottom part straight, this part's going to be covered. Okay, I can still trim some of it off. Go there. Oops. This would go in here, and it don't have to be perfect on the bottom. And then this would fit on top of that. And now we have layers of grass. So that's what I'm going to do. Way too far on the glue, but that's all right. And I'm gonna snip it. Okay. I'm gonna take this one. I want to try to line it up a bit. There we go. It could use maybe another layer down here instead of just the wide band. But anyways, there's the card. And of course you just put whatever you want for sentiment. And that's it. Alright. So glad this did turn into a long video, but anyways, you got a good look at the kit, and thanks for joining me. If you like this video, hit the like and subscribe button. Thank you for joining me, and I hope you'll join me again. Bye-bye now.